is going to be at Willow next year for kindergarten. I strongly support, you know, any mitigation measures we can continue to keep in place, as long as the public health officials are giving us that direction. I think that's the appropriate place to look for that information. My son is currently in classroom setting where most of the children he is with are not yet eligible to be vaccinated. And I, as a parent of a child in that classroom, I feel very strongly that we need to be keeping those other children safe who are not yet eligible. And I think that, I imagine that the public health officials will take that into account once that, you know, I think it seems like it's right around the corner to have this larger age group eligible for vaccines. And I think that once that takes place, then I think that we will start to likely see mitigation measures, you know, be lifted by public health officials. And I just think that lifting mask mandates right now is premature. The other point I wanted to make is just the impact that that any kind of COVID exposure or positive cases has on that younger age group is very detrimental to those kids being out of school, being out of daycare, families. We're just getting off of a week of my son's school being closed because there were two positive cases. And I think for so many families have overlap, so if we could, you know, keep our mask mandates up to keep all those kids back in school and keep numbers low until everybody, you know, ages 6 months and up is eligible. That's the appropriate thing for us to do as a community. And as Dr. McAllister said, I hope in the near future we start to see
15 seconds.
Public health officials, you know, decide that it's time to lift some of these, but I don't think it's appropriate to do quite yet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Donna Rhodes.
Thank you.
My name is Yoko Ward, I live in 1661 Cedar, and I have to say I'm very proud to be close neighbor to the young man who just so eloquently spoke. So I really don't have much to add, because I think he said it all. Thank you very much. Thank you all for what you've been doing this these past 2 years. It's amazing.
Thank you. Ashley Zagoda.
Hello, my name is Ashley Zagoda. I live at 18616 Gladwell Avenue. As I listen to these perspectives, I'm really struck by two different groups, and it's something that I would teach my kids if they were asking me something similar about whether they had to do something or not. I keep hearing in the back of my head, there's a huge difference to me between what is permanent and what is temporary, and what is voluntary and what is involuntary. People who have immune compromising issues, that is involuntary. People who want to take a mask on and put it off, that's voluntary. People who cannot escape their conditions, people who cannot escape their circumstances because of health issues, cannot be subject to someone else's choice as if it's the same level of seriousness. It's not. If someone could die as a result of someone else's decision, it's not equal, number one. Number two, my personal opinion on this matter is that the negative consequences that come as a result of wearing masks are largely, not in every instance, of course, but largely temporary. The negative consequences of not wearing masks are much more permanent, have longer lasting effects on the people who are affected by that choice. I feel that if my child is, you know, occasionally off-put by wearing masks, that's temporary. Even if they're pumped by the idea of not wearing one, that's also temporary. That joy will wear off. But the protections they get by having a longer education and a longer time in school, and the protections they get by having a safer environment are permanent. And I need them to stay in place because my job depends on me being there. My job depends, I'm a single parent. I need to work. If my kids are home, I can't. And I need to know they're safe in school. That's permanent. Thank you.
Linda Wallace.
I don't need to speak.
Okay, thank you.
I just wanted the support of it being in.
Thank you. That is everyone who has signed up. Is there anyone in the audience who still would like to address the board? If you would, if you could just raise your hand. Yes, come on.
Thank you. So I do have a medical exemption, so sorry.
Okay. Thank you.
My name is Suzanne Rickman. I live in 18201 Sacramento Avenue. And I would just like to say that from what I understand, what the judge said is that good orders from the Illinois Public Department of Health, Department of Public Health, are null and void, and that, and also ISPE, but that the local districts are can act accordingly to that. So these issues, these mandates, have been deemed null and void. So just again, as a point of law, if local districts decide to keep a mandate, then it is going against them.